Welcome to my playthrough of the Level of the Year 2019 collection, which I put together for the contest. So, I will go through every level in this pack and show off the solution. I solved every one of them already, as well, I think except one or two, maybe I solved them anyway in before, so I just wanted to be consistent, solved the last two of them or so, and redid one or two replays because there were little things and they're breaking them. And yes, I will show off the solutions also of my own nominated levels, but that will be probably the last part of this little series. So let's start with Nessie's levels. And the first one is a contest level. Butterfly Cult, let's just, yes, load in the replay. Again, no guarantee that these are all intended solutions. So, what I did here. I think he will turn into a blocker and, yes, turn this crowd towards this wall without them splatting. Here we need to traverse this gap. And we will need to build from both sides here. That's why this guy's already getting ahead. He needs to be turned around with a builder. He starts as well. These are already given climbers. I remember having to, yes, delay this guy with a fencer. And also this guy, which I made I made him a blocker to delay him, and free him with another basher. So this crowd can go safely to the exit. I bomb a hole in this wall and do a little builder and a blocker to catch these guys coming from above. They can simply bash to the other exit. Yes, and that's it. So the most difficult part about this level was getting this right, to delay these lemmings on the left side. That was by far the hardest challenge in this level. But yes, that was a pretty... In fact, yeah, all of the levels here are nice ones, but it's a level of the year pack. Well, to be nominated, at least some person must have a very great liking to your level. So you can't have just done everything wrong, let's say. And the next one, Worlds Apart. This one is also from Lemming's Destination, but I think a level which was not included in any form of contest. You need to send one worker lemming out and make both falls of the group survivable while not while avoiding to block off the exit. So I've assigned two builders here. Let him climb up again. Assign another builder so the left, so the right side can land onto that bridge here. Also blocks up the way for the climber. Now this side will be saved with a single builder. And yes, both sides can safely land down onto these bridges. Crowd can still reach the exit. Also, the climber will turn around. This level is way harder than it looks. Let's say out of the rank it was in, I think it was one of the levels I had to spend the most time with. This was not a huge amount of time, but well, it's deceiving, let's say. The next one, Blue Wedding. There it is. This was also a pretty nice one. I think it's a bit open-ended. so I can see many solutions working. Well, not a huge amount, but let's say solutions that are quite different from each other. I started with this part, digging down here. You only got two of the, each of the original skills. Yes, and I will use both of my builders in this section. Release a crowd, let him bash, and send another climber, make them both athletes. Yes, and I dig here and turn this digger around with a blocker, so I can later assign a miner onto him, mine this out. Yes, and then this remains. And here we have to make a little sacrifice. We mine down here, stop him with a bomber. We need to also bomb from the other side. And that's everything. I used all of the skills except for one blocker. I do think this is a pretty open-ended and this is not a background. But yes, this level was really enjoyable. Even though it was not nominated by me, but, I had other favorites, but this was a pretty good one. This one was nominated by me. What's it up like there? This was a very difficult one, but I really like the solution I found. I don't know if it's 100% intended, but it just felt intended to me. It felt good. And you will see what I'm talking about. You have the big problem of the two groups being very high up, we can't lose any lemmings, and there are also traps blocking the lower parts here. We will dig down a step, he will become a floater, and he after that will simply bash. He will climb and making a platform later, as I remember. Yes. And now we have a big problem. All these lemmings will turn around, falling down here. Just not a thing we want. And the big trick here is, or that I found, assigning blockers to these lemmings to simply stall them. Have only one guy falling off here, he will become a floater. And all these lemmings falling onto the top part will become blockers. It looks so easy, but it was so hard to figure that out. Here we simply build from both sides to cover up the gap. Everyone can simply land onto this bridge. Okay, and now we must wait for our athlete. We have one builder and a miner remaining. We simply build up here, turn around and mine down, and everyone can walk to the exit. Really, the biggest thing here was simply to figure out how to use all these blockers. That they can be used to stall the whole crowd, but also all being released by the basher. So that was definitely one of my highlights from the other levels. That's why I nominated. And this was another nomination by me. I can only speak for my personal nominations. I gathered them all, but I mostly forgot who we nominated who, and well, that I will remain a secret who nominated what which level. I will only speak for my nominations as far as I remember every one of them. Again, I'm a little bit forgetful in that regard. Cannibal Festival. So this took me also quite a while. I think it was like 1 or 2 hours I sat on this. So we begin by climbing up here and digging down. Now the biggest riddle was to get a lemming to bash to the left and turn around. And you will see this is a very basic method that I use here. But yes, the realization that you have to do is we simply make a builder and a blocker and send another climber over. But it was also the realization that you have to do this first, already release a crowd here into this holding pit. We need two lemmings here. You simply build into that wall, bash aside, he will splat and he turns around and goes along his way. We can pass through these. Yes, you have to really realize that you can't do this first. You have to do this part first as well. Here we can simply turn and now we build over the exit and mine in such a way that the crowd can walk up, and we also release a blocker with that same miner. That was also quite a trick that impressed me. Yes, and everybody can walk home. And this was another contest level, how to self-destruct a factory. I should have the intended solution. We have a tight timer of 2 minutes here. Climb up, make a little basher step and explode the lemming exactly after that. So that only this walker can get up, and we need a walker. The athlete goes ahead and prepares the bottom pass, while the normal lemming goes along the top way. First lemming here has enough space to bash through that wall. And this dude will, I think, fall into this part so he can prepare the middle walls. But the climber goes over to the right side. Yes, and we also have to do this little trick here, so he can turn around earlier and save the essential time we need to finish this level. Okay, one more round, I think. Yes, now I release a crowd, he has enough time to get through this wall. And he should have enough of a head start to get to the sick one. And we finish with like a little bit more than 10 seconds remaining. Was also a pretty neat level. And now we move on to Little Lemming Hideout. Was also a level from the earlier ranks of Lemming's Destination. Yes, at the start I did the trick of assigning two builders right next to each other to turn one lemming around. So we can build over this water pit from both sides. The second lemming here will build up so we can bash through this wall. Yes, and also for the first part I had to turn the release rate up. I bet there is also another method, but well, this was the first thing I found. Yes, and in the end we simply have to turn the release rate up. Okay, and the last nominated level by Nessie, the allocation strategy. This was also tricky. We've got 10 climbers at the start. Very limited resources. So we have to land most of the lemmings down here and build across to this thing and prevent them from climbing back. He of course needs to become a floater. Now we can use a platformer to turn around at this water pit. As well, it was very tempting to use a platformer here, but we need it here to turn this lemming around. We freeze the crowd with a bomber, and he should have enough time to prepare a little bridge for the other lemmings to drop onto. The main difficulty here was to realize you don't want to assign the platformer at this location. You want it in the later part to turn the lemming around. Alright, then we move on to Crane's levels. This was a contest winner. Are you kidding me? We have 100 lemmings, 98 to be safe, in a timer of 1 minute. This was a very, very nice and creative nuke solution. We stone at the start to only have 4 lemmings leading the way. We mine them out so the crowd follows in time as we are on a tight timer. We build here. These 3 become climbers so they can move up ahead. But because this is a miner, quite a few of the lemmings will end up in this pit. Now we need to time everything right. We assign a climber here at a particular timing. He is one of the first lemmings who came out of the hatch, so he will get the nuke first. We assign a second lemming to climb out, as he was also put. This was a miner, I remember. He needs to get into the exit very soon as well, because he gets the timer rather early. And for this lemming, we need to clone him. So we have 2 bombers, 2 nuke bombers, preparing the way for this crowd who gets their timers very, very late, as they were the last ones that came out of the hatch. And we finish with 4 seconds remaining. I really much like this level. I have a soft spot for good nuke solutions that don't require extreme precision. And this, well, let's say the cloning bit was a bit precision, but it was not random precision. You see that if you create nuke solutions that require precision, there are sometimes these random precision solutions where you have to contain the crowd. It is very specific thing and you can't really oversee it all, and this one was pretty much, let's say, centralized about this one lemming who needs to be nuked at the right time and who needs to be cloned at the same time. You can precisely determine that and don't have to deal with a huge crowd that's getting the nuke and explodes randomly. That's what I mean. Okay, the next level, Dropship 12. This had quite a few backward fixes, but finally came out right. We have to assign a blocker here. Send one lemming ahead. He will dig down and leave a wall here, that's important. Then send out a second one. He will climb up. And this guy, as I remember, builds through this wall so he can land safely and mines down to the other lemmings. Also prepares the last bit to get to the dropship, which serves here as the exit. There is a, let's say, invisible exit, but it's pretty much clear that this is the destination. It's a dropship 12. And yes, we mine through here and we still have 2 lemmings in the hatch, and the last lemming will, I think, yes, take out the blocker. Now we have to save him as well. Have to do it by mining with the climber, that's very important, as he can climb up again. And both of the remaining lemmings can climb up and reach a dropship. Okay, and that already leaves us to the last Crane level, Sunsoft Swindle. I think this is a remake or a reimagination of a Sunsoft level. So I have no idea if there is an intended solution here, or I guess there is quite a bit of leeway in how you do things. So I bash through all of this area, build up through here, and he will patch up the left side. I bashed from the left direction to open the path for the right side. Bash through here. And the biggest challenge was to get up through this tight tunnel. I blocked at the exit to turn the lemmings towards the hatch. Built up to the other side. Bash this guy out so I don't forget it. Now we need the climber to get up. He will release the left side so it can also help the right. And he mines down here to decrease the height needed to get up and also dig down to widen the tunnel. I let him explode so the crowd can get even further up, and the first builder has an even wider range. Yes, he can place all of the 12 steps. And now I have exactly enough builders to get up the remaining parts of the level. As I will lose this guy, and I've got only a basher, a blocker, and a bomber left, I guess this is acceptable. This seems pretty open-ended to me, to be honest. Okay, that were already all of Crane's level, and how many are there? Yes, we will still do Namida's one, and after that make a little cut. This was a contest winner and beginning of the Cromulent. I like this one very much. We have to send out a climber to the left side and also make him a floater, as a glider would simply drop onto this part. And now he platforms across this way, so we can use a glider to reach this part of the level. He needs to be less rescued later. You platform across, but leave a little hole here. Use a platformer to turn around at this little pit. And now place a second platformer exactly in a way so that we can bash through all of this. Place the last platform and now bash and clone him. The basher will continue both ways, and for the right side we have a walker to stop him, so he doesn't bash under the exit. Yes, and we also free the left guy, so that everybody can walk home. I simply love good levels that extend destructive skills. I have also a soft spot for that. This was also one of my nominations, bending the rules, as it was just such a hard level. I had to think quite a bit about it, and I really liked the solution, even if one part is, let's say, very precise and unexpected. Lemmings start out walking to the left. We have to block with the second lemming nearly immediately so that we can later glide another lemming, yes, across the blocker. Now for the most precise part of the level. Have to get one guy across, build, then send the other one in exactly a good time to block this guy. This was also the glider who we want him to be the blocker, as later he will simply glide over everything and die. So we prepare this little part, also build up to this area. And now, as we set everything up correctly, we can assign a miner who goes precisely through that bridge, turns around at the blocker and goes down. The blocker field is still onto that bridge. Are we built up? Can bash through here. Platform across, and now we assign a basher. And the blocker has to be placed also in, well, let's say there are multiple spots where this can work. But let's say it's, the spot comes every X pixels where this, what, where this will work. You will simply build across and climb to the exit, but we need one guy to get up ahead and bash through this. This is where this blocker comes in, into play. We will, here, we bash the ground. We bash the ground away under the blocker. And here, he will land on a little. On a little, let's say, plateau of the mine of the basher mask, and is still able to work up the top pass. This also happened quite a few times. As you know, bashers can create basher staircases, and if the haze is correct and the blocker stands on the correct area of the basher mask, it still can hop on to the top part of the ground. And now we have a lemming who goes up ahead and can bash through this before the crowd arrives. And well, everyone can walk home. Just need to blow this guy up and move on to the next level. Wasted Talent. I think this was also one of my nominations. This is also quite a difficult level, but I really, really enjoyed that one. There's one precise part here. We have to slow this guy down with a floater, so that we've got a stacked lemming here. We bash through here and platform with the other guy. So the basher continues to bash. You will continue to bash and also create a blockade for the other lemmings. Meanwhile, we block the crowd here and build up to this chain. And as you can see, after the bridge, you can walk up the chain into this little area and will hop out to the top pass. The basher also reaches this point in such an area where the crowd has a little gap towards it, but we need him on the lower pass. He needs to float down, but he prepares a bridge towards the exit. Still need to fence out these guys, so they can all walk up the chain into the exit. I simply loved this solution with this chain. The only part that's pretty precise is the thing at the start here with the basher and the platformer. And it's very hard to see. Okay, Mini Mayhem. This was one of the easier levels. We dig down with the second guy to prevent the crowd from following. Only one lemming gets ahead. We need to bomb here to be low enough for a builder. He bashes to catch up. We block the crowd and later bombs that blocker, so the last guy here can build over the last gap. Also have quite a tight timer, but if we do everything correctly like this, we still have a couple of seconds left. And that's already it. And that was it for this part. I will do my levels in a extra part, and next time we will go over Willems, Niche, and the mixed group. And well, until then, have a nice day.